OK. Now let's learn how to add and subtract fractions. So if we have a fraction 3/4 and 1/4, now it's important that they have the same denominator in this example. What we do is we have the same denominator, and we just add the numerators. So the answer to this is 3 plus 1 is 4, and keep the same denominator, 4. And that's equal to 1. For subtracting fractions, it works much more the same way. But it's also important here that we have the same denominator as well. 3/4 minus 1/4. You just take the first numerator, subtract the second numerator. 3 minus 1 is 2. Keep the same denominator again, 2/4. And that is equal to 1/2. When you're adding fractions with different denominators, there's another step that you need to do. If I add 3/4 and 1/3, I need to first make them have the common denominator. The easiest way to do that is to just multiply the two denominators together to get 12ths. So 3/4 in 12ths, I would have to do, so I'm going to change these to all have the same denominator. So to get 12 from 4, I multiply by 3. So I multiply the top by 3 as well. 3/4 is equivalent to 9/12. To get this denominator to be 12, I multiply by 4. So I must do the same for the numerator as well. Now that I have fractions with the same denominator, I can just add the numerators. That's how you add fractions with different denominators. Now, to subtract fractions with different denominators, let's have another fraction, let's say, 3/4 minus 1/3. You can't subtract them directly, so we need to change them to have a common denominator. What we're going to do is here, we're going to make this into 12ths. To do that, we multiply the top and bottom by 3 over 3, which is 1. And to get this into 12ths, we multiply the top and bottom by 4. 3/4 is equivalent to 9/12, and 1/3 is equivalent to 4/12. So we haven't changed the problem, but we have gotten common denominators, which will allow us to do the subtraction. 9 minus 4 is 5. And that's it. That's how you subtract fractions with different denominators.